So what I'd like to do is actually step through a concrete counterexample that really does show that a particular way of doing this kind of training can fail in the worst case. And this is an example due to Lehman Baird, and it's, you know, devious and clever.
I like devious and clever.
So here's a really simple MDP. You ready? It's got six states and then a seventh absorbing state.
Okay.
For each state, there's exactly one action. There's no stochasticity. There's no rewards of any kind. They're all zero. So this is a really simple example, right?
Sure. That seems pretty straightforward.
All right. So then what is the optimal value function and policy for this example?
The optimal value function or the optimal policy?
I asked for both.
There is no optimal policy. It doesn't matter what you do. You just have to do the one thing.
There's only one policy, and it is optimal by definition of optimal.
And the value function, the proper value function would be zero everywhere.
Zeros everywhere, right, because there's no rewards anywhere. So, right, so this is super-duper simple. And if we had to learn this using Q-learning or something like that, presumably this would actually learn quite quickly. What we're going to do, though, to make life difficult, is we're going to do this in a function approximation setting, linear function approximation, with this following set of features. So there's the seven states in the picture, and associated with each state is a feature vector, and there's eight features that are part of that. Feature 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Feature 0 is 1 for all these states and 7 for this, for the repeating state. And interestingly, we have it set up so that these other features are actually completely indicative of which state you're in. So state 1 has feature 1 being true. State 2 has feature 2 being true. State 3 has feature 3 being true, or at least, and by true, I mean 2, I guess.
2, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so that's kind of the representation here. So state 6 looks like 1 and then 0 is everywhere except for feature 6, which has a 2 and then a 0, right? So this feature representation is actually really close to being just a table.
Yeah.
So I'm going to say near tabular, in the sense that if we get rid of this first feature, there's going to be one weight that represents the value for state 1 and one weight that represents the value for state 2 and so forth, and one weight that represents the value for state 7. And so it's exactly just a table, one weight or one table entry per state.
Right.
And all we've done is kind of made it a little bit, you know, more by having this extra feature that we ought to be able to just ignore, right?
Mm-hmm.
And we should be able to represent things pretty well. No, so in fact, I think it's worth asking, can we represent the optimal value function using this set of weights, right? So if our parameters are W0 through W7, is there a way to set them so that the value function that we get is the actual value function for this MDP?
Sure. There's one easy one.
And what's that?
Set them all to zero.
Right.